Hey guys, it's Chelsea from The Financial Diet, and this week's video is brought to you by Credit Repair. And this week, I wanted to talk to you about common healthy products that you've probably seen all around you in stores, in your friends' medicine cabinets, or perhaps most notably on your social media feeds. These are products that are often marketed to us as quick fixes to long-term health problems, easy ways to make ourselves look aesthetically better, or ways to cleanse ourselves of problems and toxins we didn't even know we had. Usually notable for their dubious scientific nature and ubiquity on places like Instagram, these are the kind of health products that you should almost universally steer clear of. We'll talk a little bit about the products themselves, as well as the ways in which they tend to be sold to us, so we can get a better handle on avoiding them altogether. So let's get right into it with seven healthy purchases that are total wastes of money. Number one is detox products. Now, detoxes are a bit difficult to pin down because they can come in all forms, and not all of them even necessarily require you to buy something, although a lot of them do. Some detoxes are really just about drinking a ton of water and making sure to get a lot of exercise and, I guess, sweat out the demons or whatever the idea is. But a lot of them do require you to buy things. And whether it's just drinking a ton of water or buying some of these dubious detox products, the concept around detoxes generally remains the same. And by the same, I mean bullshit. The basic idea is that modern life results in the accumulation of toxins in your body, and every now and then you should have a tune-up by flushing those toxins out. The specific toxins are never mentioned. There's also no basic science reason or clinical evidence to support the notion that the methods recommended actually remove any specific toxins from the body. Now, there are a couple of things to understand when it comes to grasping why this whole detox idea is really dubious. And perhaps the most important one is that if you're taking care of your body generally, your body serves those functions as it stands. The healthy body has kidneys, a liver, skin, even lungs that are detoxifying as we speak. There is no known way, certainly not through detox treatments, to make something that works perfectly well in a healthy body work better. And one place that you've probably been seeing a lot of advertisements for detox teas, notably, is Instagram. And excuse me for the judgment here, because I know we promote side hustles quite a bit on The Financial Diet, but how rich exactly do the Kardashians have to be before they'll stop promoting these products on their Instagram? It is not only incredibly tacky and low rent for them to be constantly doing it, but they're also knowingly hawking products that are at the very best useless and at the very worst dangerous. Most of these detox teas are actually just diuretics and laxatives. What does that mean? They make you pee and poop a lot. And while many of these teas are marketed with the idea of flushing toxins out of your body, really what most people are buying for them is a quick way to lose weight. And yes, in many cases, if you are peeing and pooping a bunch in a short span of time, the scale will go down at least for a little bit. But this is not any real or sustainable weight loss. And more importantly, this has nothing to do with clarifying non-existent toxins from your body. And beyond that, common side effects of these detox teas tend to be things like elevated heart rate, high blood pressure, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, etc. These products are not regulated by the FDA. The producers can put basically anything they want into them. And there is certainly no one who is less qualified to be giving you health and nutritional advice than a bunch of Instagram models. Long story short, detox products are bullshit, as is the concept of flushing toxins out of your body with a tea that makes you poop. Number two is vitamin supplements. Now, this one may be the most controversial point, because yes, vitamins are an essential component of a daily diet. But the truth is, a healthy and balanced diet with an eye toward making sure you are getting these vitamins and nutrients is one that does not need additional vitamin supplements. Once someone has reached the appropriate level of that vitamin intake, more of that vitamin is not going to do anything. And while excessive intake of any one vitamin is likely not going to harm you, they can reach toxic levels and begin to produce negative side effects if you start taking way too much of them. But often the consequence of these vitamin supplements are indirect, because they allow people to not eat the balanced diet they should be eating, or even potentially seek out more important medications and treatments because they're using vitamin supplements that are not even calibrated to their needs. For example, waking up and taking a multivitamin every day because you're not eating fruits and vegetables is not a solution. Not only are there other things in those fruits and vegetables that you should be consuming, It's also probably leading you to eat a much crappier diet full of a bunch of stuff you don't need than you otherwise would. Sometimes there can be a use for specific supplements of certain vitamins. There are people who experience deficiencies, have a hard time absorbing them, etc. But this is a conversation to have with a doctor based on your individual needs and diet. And if you are not getting enough of a certain vitamin, it is much healthier to attempt to meet those needs naturally through eating better foods. So not all vitamin supplements are a waste of money, but just taking unconsidered vitamins as a replacement for eating a healthy diet is. Number three is cleanses. Now, this one is pretty similar to detoxes in the sense that it's a bunch of woo-woo bullshit around, I don't know, little tiny like Miss Pac-Man ghost looking evil toxins living in your body that you have to get rid of every now and again. But this one even further pushes the dubious health advice into seriously disordered eating territory. There are all kinds of cleanses out there, but the one that you may be most familiar with is called the Master Cleanse, where essentially a large part or even sometimes all of your diet for a certain frame of time is replaced by a combination of water, lemon, cayenne pepper, and honey or agave or some variation of that. Now, there should be no mistake made here. The primary objective of things like the Master Cleanse, no matter what people say, is to lose a lot of weight in a short amount of time. And there's absolutely no mystery why it leads you to do that, because you are radically cutting the number of calories you consume during those days. But these drastic calorie-cutting cleanses have both short and long-term impacts on the body, and not good ones. So yes, if I'm being perfectly intellectually honest, I will say that they will often result in you losing a larger amount of weight in a shorter amount of time than you normally would with a more regimented diet. But A, that weight loss is likely to be almost immediately reversed when you start eating normally, but also that cleanse itself is super dangerous in other ways. That kind of drastic calorie reduction can result in dehydration, dizziness, fatigue, even moments of unconsciousness, and on the long term can have serious negative impacts on your body's metabolism. And just like detoxification, these cleanses are not backed up by real studies, and they're certainly not something a doctor would recommend to you. In 2019, it's become somewhat taboo to speak in open terms about the drastic calorie cutting that women and some men have been engaged in for centuries. Diet books and women's magazines just a few decades ago used to openly teach you how to starve yourself down to a slightly lower dress size in time for that holiday party. But now those same dangerous bits of diet advice are given a tiny little patina of health consciousness and passed off as anything other than a crash liquid diet. In certain extreme forms, this obsessive focus on health as a way to maintain a low weight has a name. It's called orthorexia. But even if it's something you're engaging in on a just occasional level to cleanse yourself down into that cute new dress, it's not a healthy way to lose weight. And it's also not healthy to bullshit yourself into thinking it has anything to do with your overall health. Because on what planet is drinking a bunch of sugar water instead of eating food something that you do to be healthier? Number four is candy-like protein bars. Now listen, I would like to be perfectly transparent here and say that I actually enjoy protein bars as candy bars. A lot of them have this kind of like weird chalky taste and texture that I find really enjoyable. But I am enjoying them as a sweet treat. I am not enjoying them as some kind of healthful decision for my body. It's a replacement for a Snickers, not a balanced dinner. In fact, most of the protein bars on the market are loaded with more of the waist-widening sweet stuff than a Snickers. And because you consider them a health food that you can eat every day, rather than a once-in-a-while treat, they can be more likely to hamper your weight loss or tone-up efforts than to help them. Essentially, if you're looking for a high-protein, convenient snack, there are about 100 things that you could eat that are overall better for you and not as jam-packed with unnecessary refined sugar than a protein bar. And yes, occasionally, if you just need something on the go and there happens to be one within reach, it's not going to kill you. But it's certainly not any kind of long-term replacement for a balanced diet, nor should you trick yourself into thinking that it's much better for you than your average Snickers. If you, like me, find their weird chewy chalkiness to be addictive all their own, you are entitled to have one for dessert every now and again. but don't think it's a health food. Number 5 is body wraps and waist trainers. Now, I must be honest here and say that there's a bit of this that I find so offensive on a much more principled slash historical feminist level than I do a dubious health level. And that is, how long did women fight to get out of having to wear corsets just to willingly put ourselves back into them to go work out in? And more importantly, didn't we look back at the negative health impacts of wearing a corset on women and say, wow, what an awesome thing that we no longer have to move around all our internal organs to be accepted by society? Apparently not, because they're back in vogue. And as one spinal surgeon put it, if I were to take a rubber band and wrap it around my finger tightly and leave it there for an hour, I'm going to have an indentation in my soft tissue, but it's not going to be permanent. An hour later, my finger is going to look normal again. However, the damage caused by a waist trainer could be permanent. My focuses as a spinal surgeon are the musculature effects and what effect does it have on the spine, the bones, the ligaments, the nerves. And certainly there can be some significant side effects with the prolonged use of these types of devices. It just crams all of your organs together, so over a long period of time, wearing it too much and too frequently, it can cause damage. And listen, what am I, perfect? Of course I wear Spanx sometimes with the right dress. But there's an enormous difference between wanting to get a dress to lay nice and flatly on you throughout a huge night of eating and drinking, and wearing something that is specifically designed to reshape the look of your torso. These trainers are worn with an eye to shaving actual inches off your body even when you take them off. In the short term, it can lead to you passing out from lack of air because you're not able to properly fill your lungs. And in the long term, they can have serious damage on things like the placements of your organs, as well as your nerves and muscles. The point is, there's no surprise. Corsets were really bad for us, and so is wearing waist trainers and body shapers on a long-term basis. And just like several of our other items here today, the weight loss effects that they might have are largely illusions. Number 6 is brand name medicine. And I've actually mentioned this in a recent video, but it's important to remember. The FDA requires generic medicines to have the same efficacy and active ingredients as their brand name counterparts. Just like most brand name versus generic products, the difference in price usually comes down to things like marketing, packaging, the amount of advertising they're doing for the product, even the size of the packaging can have a huge impact. And while generic versions are not available for all medications, they're available for an enormous amount of them. And because they're not constantly fighting for the attention of doctors, pharmacists, and your dollars, they're often able to deliver the same quality product for a fraction of the price. And while some insurance providers actually require you to use the generic version of a drug if it's available, others don't, which could lead you to having a larger copay or having to pay out of pocket without needing to. Taking a few minutes to always make sure that you've checked the generic option, whether for a prescription or over-the-counter drug, can save you hundreds of dollars. And unlike the bagged cereals on the bottom shelf, which sometimes do have a really different taste than their brand name counterparts, you can trust that this isn't going to be a case of a cheaper drug which doesn't have as much effectiveness. And lastly, number 7, which I hope ties these all together with a nice little fake healthy bow, is health MLMs. Before I get into it, I should clarify that if you're not familiar with the term, MLM stands for multi-level marketing schemes, essentially a pyramid scheme. Here are just a few of the bullshit health MLMs you've probably seen on your social media. Advocare, Beachbody, It Works. Whether we're talking about the waist trainers, the detox supplements, the protein bars, the workout stuff, you are almost certainly guaranteed on a weekly, if not daily basis, to see these products being hawked on your social media feeds by people you know in your real life in addition to influencers. And with almost no exceptions, these products are shown to have little to no effect or sometimes adverse effects, as described in this video. And while a lot of them like to put themselves under the guise of health, as you can probably guess, most of them are just about glorified weight loss tools and occasionally getting bigger muscles. You pay for the right to be able to sell these products, and that's how the company makes most of their money, not by you actually selling them. You also sometimes have to buy enormous amounts of inventory in order to maintain that right to sell, another way they make their money. But there are a couple of things that we should talk about when it comes to health MLMs outside of just their obvious dubious health effects. The first is that these companies tend to target women and can have disastrous financial effects on them. Every year, women are driven deep into debt by multi-level marketing companies. These firms, many of which have been accused of operating as glorified pyramid schemes, rely on a network of sales reps who sell their products primarily through social media. In recent years, MLMs have co-opted the language of entrepreneurs entrepreneurship, telling primarily young women, stay-at-home moms, and military spouses that they can become self-employed girl bosses if they simply spend thousands of dollars in savings to buy up inventory and sell it to their friends. And if you've ever considered getting into one of them yourself, just remember, or perhaps remind someone that you love, that according to a 2017 report by the Consumer Awareness Institute, 99% of people who get involved with MLMs actually lose money. But perhaps the other thing that's important to talk about when we think about these health MLMs is just how much there can be a social pressure to not push back on them, because oftentimes the people involved are people that you actually know and care about in real life. But the truth is that if you do care about one of these people who's involved in one of these schemes, not only is it important to remember that these products are often dangerous and at the very best useless, but they're also, as institutions, incredibly financially predatory. Long story short, friends don't let friends MLM. Whether you've been targeted by one of these products on social media, heard a friend rave about her crash liquid cleanse that allowed her to lose a bunch of weight before her big event, or thought about throwing yet another sugar-filled bar into your bag as a healthy alternative to lunch, remember that often the things that are targeted to us in the name of health are only promising loss in the form of money coming out of your wallet. But if you want to do something that's actually smart for your wallet today, you should think about bringing up your credit score. And if you want help making your credit score as healthy as it can be, you should talk to Credit Repair.
Want help improving your credit score? We're partnering with CreditRepair.com to give select followers support from their professional team. We'll follow along for 6 months as you work on building your credit, and the services will be comped by CreditRepair.com, who will help identify questionable negative items hurting your score and build you a custom game plan. They'll also challenge the bureaus and your creditors to help make your credit score reflect accurately and fairly. This opportunity is open to any U.S. resident who feels their current score is less than ideal, no matter the situation or the reason. If you think you could benefit from this and would be open to sharing your experience with TFD's community, email hello@thefinancialdiet.com with the subject title Credit Repair and let us know a little about your current credit situation and goals. We'll notify you if you've been selected by March 8, 2019. Participants must be U.S. residents, and they will not be required to endorse CreditRepair.com unless they had a genuinely positive experience, but will be asked to disclose their current score and share the experience with our audience.
As always, guys, thank you for watching, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and to come back every Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday for new and awesome videos. Bye!